Welcome back once again to my YouTube channel, Fun Learning with Smita. Thank you for showering with lots of love and support in all my previous videos, which has encouraged me to create this video today. Today I'll be teaching you all how to make use of Padlet application. So before starting, let me teach you or give you a gist about what is this Padlet application all about. So the educators can make use of Padlet application in order to carry out their lesson in synchronization mode. If you want your lessons not to be teacher-centric and you want your students to interact, involve, write, then this application is the best. So, to create an account in Padlet, you will have to type Padlet in the Google tab, and like any other application, you will have to log in, create an account using your email ID. As I've already done this, you can see on the screen they have directed me to the dashboard. In case you are a student and you want to join a Padlet created by a teacher, you will have to paste the link over here and click on submit button, and you would be directed to the Padlet created by your teacher. In case you do not want to start from the scratch and you want some ready-made templates, then you can visit the gallery and you can see there are several topics written over here. Based on that, quiz, you know, Padlets have been created. So I'll show you one. For example, this, you can see how beautiful this looks like. Image is there, title is there, a small description, title of the Padlet. I'll show you one more. For example, if you want your students to create an assignment based on tourism, you can ask them to create in this way. I'll show you one more. As soon as you click on this, you get an image based on that place and a small one-liner. So now let me teach you how to create a Padlet like this so that you can make your lectures much more interactive. So I'll just to create a Padlet, you can click on make a Padlet, and then you will be directed to such a screen. So I have already created one black board themed Padlet. I'll click on the add post option and I'll just type the question over here. For example, I want my students to tell me about what are the different forms of business. So I have posted the question. I want to involve or maybe attach or upload an image. So I'll click on the first option. I have already made use of this. So for example, if I want the second image, I'll just click on this and you can see an image along with a question is there. I will be wanting to create one more box, so let me just click on this. I'll type the second question over here, which is, what are the skills which are required in an entrepreneur? Again, if you want to add any YouTube video or anything, you can click on link and directly paste the URL over here, and videos or images or any such articles, blogs, and that would be pasted over here. In case you have it ready-made in your, what do we say, in your file section of your computer, you can just click on pick file. And they will show you a variety of photos which is already there in your computer. And I'll just click on any appropriate image and click on open option. It takes some time to upload. As soon as it is done, you can see the question along with the images here. You can drag it if you want. If you want to delete any post, you can click on delete option. In case at the last minute you remember you want to make some edited, you want to edit it, you will have to click on the first option, that is edit, and you can make changes in the question as well. These three dots have different options, like deleting the post, set as a cover, you want to expand the size of the post, you want to copy the post, or you want to edit the post color or anything. Okay, I'll just go on to the right hand corner, that is the settings option, to show you what changes you will have to make in the settings. The first one is title. You can write any title. If you are teaching of accounts topic, you can write it as accounts. Description, you can write small description would be given, which would be given over here. If you want any icon to be placed over here, you can click on icon where there are different emoticons. For example, I want this one. I'll just click it and you can see it has come over here. This one, and it has come. That's it. Then this is the link which would be used by you, that is the educators, in order to share it with your students. So you will have to copy this link, paste it anywhere where your students can make access to. As soon as they click on the link, they would be directed to this Padlet which you have created. So this is a unique link of your Padlet. You can click on the wallpaper option in order to get different types of wallpapers. It can be solid color like this, gradient in this form, texture and pattern in this form, or any appropriate image like this. Then, after selecting appropriate wallpaper, you have different color schemes also. Like, as soon as I click black, it came in black. And this way, the other way around. The font style you can see over here. As soon as I click on different font styles, the font style of the questions change. Now, before actually sharing the link with your students, you will have to make changes in this setting. Comment, you will have to enable it. So you can see, as soon as I clicked on enable, add comment option has come over here. You can save your settings and close it. Once you share the link, for example, option share, once you copy the link and share it with your students, they can easily access this particular dashboard of yours, this particular Padlet of yours, and they can actually type the comment over here. So I'll just show, for example, I just write an answer over here. And then they will click on this and it will appear like this to you all. So as soon as they go on posting, you will have to refresh so that it would be updated and you can see all the comments which have been posted by your students. In the share option, you will have to make changes in the privacy option. You will have to change the privacy to public, because if you keep it secret or private, there is a chance that not all your students would be able to access it. So keep it public. What do you want your visitors to do? Do you want them to write? Do you want to just read the Padlet? So for example, you can create a summarization or a mind map or a flowchart sort of thing so that you can summarize your lecture. So if you want them to just read, you can read. If you want your collaborator to edit, you can give the editing rights. So for now, I'll just select on writing option. And that's it. And I'll save the settings. And then I can go back and close this. That's all about this Padlet application. I want to keep my videos short. So you can add and as many posts as you want like this. And you can create and you can rearrange it, you can expand it, you can change the position and make it much more creative. So hope you like this video, and I hope all my students and my teachers would be sharing this videos with each other and let others also know about this beautiful application and make use of this application in your lessons. Thank you so much.